Welcome, you're watching Netraj TV Talk Time, and we have the guest, His Excellency Mr. Venu Rajamouli, Ambassador of the Republic of India. Welcome in our program.
Thank you, pleasure to be here.
Fine. So, Mr. Ambassador, you're appointed since last June 2017. Can you tell something about your latest activities in Holland?
Well, it has been action-packed ever since I came here. I arrived in Holland on the 10th of June.
Okay.
14th of June, I presented my credentials to the King of Holland, King Willem Alexander. I had an opportunity to meet him, have a nice conversation with him. 18th of June was International Yoga Day.
Yeah,
we organized it in a big way in the atrium of the City Hall in The Hague.
Yeah.
For the first time, we had about 1,000 people who joined and who did yoga together.
Yeah, actually, we showed some sequences of the yoga
program.
Happy,
and I hope more and more people can join in the International Yoga Day celebrations in the future, and we can even do it in Amsterdam if possible. Then 19th, I had the Chief Minister of West Bengal, Mamata Banerjee, who came here with a big business delegation and a media delegation. She also won a special prize from the United Nations, the UN Public Service Forum prize. She got the first prize.
So what was the reason for
that? That was for a special program that the West Bengal government is implementing for the girl child.
Okay.
For children, for the women children or the girl children.
Yeah.
So, and then she left on the 24th and 27th of June. Mm-hmm. As you know, Prime Minister Modi was here in a very successful visit. It was a short visit for about 8 hours, but it was very intense and action. It was full of very fruitful, very productive activities.
Yeah. So, His Excellency, can you tell something about the preparation during that visit from Prime Minister Narendra Modi? Because as we know, the Netherlands has the largest second population of people of Indian origin, next to the UK, and especially Suriname, Hindustani diaspora. So, can you tell something about this?
Yes, absolutely. One, the preparations were very comprehensive because Prime Minister Modi met the Prime Minister of Netherlands, Mark Rutte.
Yeah.
He met four other ministers.
Yeah.
He had an interaction with CEOs of leading Dutch companies, 15 CEOs. He had an interaction for about an hour.
Okay.
And he called on the king.
Mm-hmm.
And he separately also met the queen, who is the UN Secretary General's special advocate for financial inclusion.
Yeah.
We have in India today, the Prime Minister has launched what is known as the Jan Dhan Yojana, which is the largest financial inclusion program anywhere in the world.
What is the meaning of that?
Jan means people.
Yeah.
Dhan means money.
Money.
So Yojana means program. So the program for the people's money,
essentially
encouraging every Indian to open bank accounts and to save money in banks and to use digital money rather than use cash anymore.
Yeah.
So it's a huge success. We have added in a span of about few months, over 240 million bank accounts were newly opened.
Yeah.
And the Queen was full of praise for that. And on top of that, the biggest highlight of his visit was the address that he made to the Indian community.
Yeah.
Within just about 3-4 days of preparation, we were able to mobilize around 3,000 Indians.
Yeah, we were there.
You
we
also, there. You
we,
also
we,
covered
we,
it.
We visited the venue.
So we did everything online. So we opened a registration site online. We invited people to come and register to come and hear the Prime Minister speak.
Mm.
And we were very happy at the audience we had. And the Prime Minister made an extremely important speech. And the most important element of his speech was how much the Surinamese Indian community is dear to the people of India.
Yeah, it was a historical and let's say for us, my grandfather is also from India. I'm born here in Holland. It was really significant speech and really emotional also for the people who attended.
That's right. So essentially the Prime Minister's message was that the Indian community as a whole, we should not say Surinamese, Hindustani, we should not say people from India.
Yeah.
We are all one big family. It doesn't matter what your passport is, whether you have a Dutch passport or an Indian passport.
Mm.
It doesn't matter whether you speak Dutch or English or Hindi, but we are all connected by our love for India, for its religion, for its culture, for its language, for the food of India.
Regarding the language, aap kuch Hindi kuch baat kar
sakte? Zarur, zarur Hindi mein baat kar sakta hoon. To Prime Minister sahab ne bhi us din Hindi mein baat kiya tha. Aur unhone itni achhi tarah ये बोला
yeah.
कि अगर जो लोग जिनका एंसेस्टर्स
yeah.
इंडिया से सुरिनाम गए थे
yeah.
और सुरिनाम से यहाँ आए हुए हैं
yeah.
150 साल के बाद अभी भी अपनी भाषा बोल सकते हैं,
संस्कृति
का रक्षा कर सकते हैं
yeah.
अपनी रिलीजन को आदर करते हैं
yeah.
तो ये बहुत अच्छे लोग हैं
yeah.
और कभी कभी जो लोग नया आए हैं इंडिया से उनका सोचना पड़ेगा कि वो भी 150 साल बाद
हाँ.
इंडिया के साथ इतना करीब रहेंगे इतना क्लोज रहेंगे कि नहीं. और उन्होंने एक चीज बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट बोला कि जितने भी सुरिनामी हिंदुस्तानी है यहाँ वो सब ज्यादातर अभी डच सिटीजन्स है लेकिन प्राइम मिनिस्टर साहब ने उनसे अपील किया कि वो ओसीआई कार्ड ले. ये ओसीआई कार्ड ओवरसीज सिटीजन ऑफ इंडिया कार्ड है और ये कार्ड लेने से अब उनको इंडिया के साथ एक परमानेंट कनेक्शन हो जाता है.
या सो फॉर द व्यूअर्स द जस्ट व्यूअर्स एंड द पीपल हु डोंट अंडरस्टैंड हिंदी द एंबेसडर हिज एक्सेलेंसी गिव्स अ शॉर्ट एक्सप्लेनेशन अबाउट द टाइज बिटवीन द ओरिजिनल सुरिनामी हिंदुस्तानी हु केम फ्रॉम इंडिया देयर एंसेस्टर्स एंड द इंपॉर्टेंस व्हिच मिस्टर प्राइम द प्राइम मिनिस्टर मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी गेव इन हिज स्पीच एंड ऑल्सो द डायस्पोरा लिंक व्हाट वी हैव टुगेदर.
दैट्स राइट.
Holland, so, India, and Suriname.
If I can explain that a little more, the Prime Minister felt that the Indian community should be united as one whole.
Mm-hmm.
And all those who are Dutch citizens, he appealed to them to take the overseas citizen of India card so that it becomes an umbilical cord connecting them to India.
Yeah.
And if you take the OCI card,
mm-hmm.
you get a lifetime visa to go to India, especially if children take, then throughout their lifetime, they can go to India.
Mm-hmm.
You can open bank accounts in India.
Yeah.
The interest rate in India for savings is very high compared to Netherlands. So you can take advantage of that.
Mm-hmm.
You can work in India.
Mm-hmm.
You can stay in India without any restriction. You can stay any length of time yeah. if you want.
I think this was also implemented by Prime Minister Narendra Modi to give a lifetime
visa.
Visa.
So no, the lifetime visa had started sometime back, but Prime Minister Modi is encouraging Indians abroad.
Okay.
Whoever is not, those who have an Indian citizen, they have Indian passport. But those who don't have Indian passport, he says, please take this overseas citizen of India card so that it becomes a lifetime connection for you with India. You can come and go very conveniently, very easily. You never have to go to an embassy and apply for a visa after that. You just have to apply once.
Okay. His Excellency, the initial cultural agreement between the Netherlands and India are widespread and in the field of education, science, or the trade fields. So, can you tell something about this?
Let me tell you very clearly. The main India and Netherlands have very good relations.
Okay.
They have very good political relations. That relations has been strengthened by the visit of Prime Minister Modi to Netherlands.
Yeah.
But going beyond that, we want to have a close, we also have a very close economic and commercial relationship. There are over 200 Indian companies in Netherlands and over 200 Dutch companies in India.
Okay.
Companies like Philips, companies like Shell, companies like Unilever, which has been there for a very, very long time. Philips has been there for almost 130 years.
Yeah.
So we want to strengthen the economic and commercial relationship. Mm. But beyond that, we want to strengthen the people-to-people connection.
Yeah.
We want more and more tourists to go from Netherlands to India.
Yeah.
And each one of our Surinamese friends can be ambassadors for India. The Prime Minister used the word Rashtradoot. You can be an ambassador of the whole country, of the whole nation, of our civilization, of our culture. So we would like the Surinamese Hindustanis in particular, but all Indians, to unite and work to spread the message of India here in Netherlands, to invite more Dutch people to come to India, to do more economic and business activity.
Okay.
And we would like the embassy proposes in follow-up to Prime Minister Modi's visit to organize a number of events in which we want maximum participation by Indians and we want all Indians to come together and to work closely with the embassy for the benefit of Netherlands, for the benefit of India.
His Excellency, can you tell something about the coming activities regarding your function as ambassador in Holland?
The Embassy of India is planning a number of activities in the coming days. And all these activities are a follow-up to Prime Minister Modi's visit.
Yeah.
We are going to focus our efforts in two directions, especially with regard to the community.
Okay.
One is to try and spread information about the OCI card and to encourage as many people to come and take OCI card. And two, to have as many events as possible which bring the community together.
Yeah.
So for the spreading the OCI card, we are going to do several things. One, August 4th to 6th in The Hague, there is going to be the Milan Summer Festival, which I believe is one of the largest gatherings of the diaspora here on the European
Union. That's correct, yeah.
So we will, the embassy will have a special stall at the Milan Summer Festival. Anybody who has any query, anybody who has any question, if they want to come and register and say, I want to apply for an OCA card, my staff will be there to help them and to guide them through the process.
Okay.
Secondly, on August 15th, as you probably know, is India's Independence Day. Republic Day is January 26th.
Yeah.
August 15th is India's Independence Day.
Yeah.
And this August 15th is very special because it is our 70th Independence Day.
Yeah.
We got our freedom in 1947 and this is 2017.
Yeah.
It is also special because India and Netherlands established diplomatic relations in 1947. So we are also completing 70 years of friendship between India and Netherlands.
Yeah, historical ties.
That's right. So on August 15th, for the first time, we are going to have a big flag hoisting ceremony at the residence of the ambassador in Wassenaar, which is an open event. It is, we would like to invite all members of our community. We would like to invite all friends of India, Dutch citizens, any of the Indian community, if they want to bring friends, please. We will once again have an online registration system just so that we know the numbers, but everybody is welcome. We will publicize it, we will advertise it on our social media and through TV channels like yours.
Okay, thank you.
So we invite everybody to come on the morning of August 15th at 10 o'clock to the ambassador's residence in Wassenaar and be part of the Independence Day event. On the evening of August 15th, we are again going to have a big seminar, cultural program in The Hague, where we hope some prominent Dutch dignitaries will come and participate and they will speak about what India has achieved in 70 years.
So that's not a cultural program, it's more like a seminar.
It's a combination. There's a lot of cultural program, but there will be some speeches.
Yeah, regarding celebrations.
70 years achievement.
Yeah.
And then we are going to have on September 2nd, there is an embassy festival being organized in The Hague where all embassies will participate. There again, India will have a food stall which is going to be run by Sharavana Bhavan of Amsterdam. And we will have a stall to give information on India, on tourism, on OCI, etc. Then on September 9th is Monuments Day. The Indian Ambassador's House in Wassenaar is a heritage monument. And the municipality of Wassenaar has requested us to open it out to the public that day. So we welcome all our Indian and Dutch friends to come see the beautiful monument that is the ambassador's residence in Wassenaar. And on October 2nd, which is Gandhi Jayanti, we want to have a big program and we invite volunteers from the Indian community to come and join hands. We would like to have one Dutch speaker and one Indian, one English speaker to together go to schools in Netherlands, to universities in Netherlands and talk about Mahatma Gandhi, talk about the message of non-violence, how India won freedom, etc. And we are also hoping to have a big gathering in The Hague to mark Gandhi Jayanti on the evening of October 1st.
Yeah, you mentioned this is to look a very historical point, Mahatma Gandhi. So there's also, in collaboration with the Indian Embassy, we have this cultural event, Gandhi Cultural Center. Can you tell something about this?
Yeah, there is a cultural center in The Hague, which is run by the embassy, which provides free yoga classes. It provides free Hindi classes.
Okay.
And there are tabla classes which happen there. And they have an auditorium which local organizations can come and use for their cultural activities. And our teachers go from place to place supporting cultural activities in the Netherlands.
Yeah.
So the goal of the cultural center is to spread knowledge about Indian culture amongst the Dutch people, and to provide cultural offerings to the Indian people,
yeah,
and to strengthen friendship. There are two more events, let me say. In The Hague, there is going to be a Holland-India festival, mm-hmm. which will also begin around the same time as Gandhi Jayanti.
Yeah.
There is going to be a new book on Mahatma Gandhi, mm-hmm. a pictorial book published in English and Dutch.
Okay.
That will also be released around that time.
Yeah.
And here in Amsterdam, in the new church, there's going to be a big exhibition opening by end of September,
mm-hmm.
which will showcase Mahatma Gandhi, Nelson Mandela, and Martin Luther King.
Yeah.
And for that exhibition, some personal items used by Mahatma Gandhi from Sabarmati Ashram in Gujarat.
Yeah. So there's very, a lot of activities, cultural activities, and of course, the 15th of August, one of the most
August
important...
15th, Independence Day.
Independence Day, very...
And Gandhi Jayanti, October 1st and 2nd. So I invite all your viewers to send emails, to contact us in the embassy, so that we can all come together and organize these events in a big way. And yeah. we can unite our community and we can show what our strength is.
Yeah, His Excellency, I'd like to come back to the point from, the Suriname Hindustani diaspora and the people who are visiting India as a tourist. Can you tell something about this? Because we see there are a lot of visa possibilities now. We also have the opportunity to go online very fast.
Yes, the visa has become very easy. Any tourist can apply for an online visa. Once again, for the Surinamese Hindustanis, we would recommend the OCI card because it's a lifetime visa. They never need to take a visa after that once they take it.
Yeah.
But for other Dutch citizens, mm-hmm. we would strongly recommend the online visa.
Okay.
You can go online and apply, and within a few days, you will get your visa.
Yeah.
And also for those who are going to India for business,
yeah.
we now have a 5-year multiple entry visa, which makes it very convenient to go to India, do business.
Yeah, I think that Prime Minister Narendra Modi mentioned that in his speech. So, the Indian embassy also deals with several issues like bilateral relations, trade issues, and also, let's say, students,
yes,
scholarship.
Yes.
Can you tell something about this?
Well, there are a number of programs which are there in India for children of the Indian diaspora.
Okay.
For example, there is a program called the Know India program.
If
you go onto the embassy website, the details are available there.
Yeah.
And I would encourage people to apply for this Know India program.
Mm-hmm.
And if they get selected, then they get a trip to India and they can travel around India.
Can you tell in short what is the criteria a little bit?
Anybody can apply. I think there is an age limit,
yeah.
but anybody can apply and they are selected for this Know India program.
Mm.
All the details are available on our website.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay. And if they have any confusion, they can just send an email into us and we can answer these questions. We have also scholarships. ICCR, the Indian Council for Cultural Relations,
mm-hmm.
offers scholarships to study in India, in Indian universities, in areas like dance, music, art, theatre, etc., which people can apply for.
Yeah.
And there are a large number of Indian students who come to the Netherlands
mm-hmm.
and are studying in different universities here. Their numbers are also growing rapidly.
Okay.
So we encourage them to come and be in touch with the embassy.
Mm-hmm.
We would like to organize all our students across Netherlands
mm-hmm.
so that the embassy can be of support to them whenever they have a problem or whenever they need something, and they can in turn be part of all the activities that we organize.
Okay, so there are a lot of activities, cultural activities, business relations. Can you finally give your message to our viewers, the diaspora viewers?
My message is the Indian embassy is here for all of you. We want to reach out to you. We want to connect to you with you. We want to help and support you. And in turn, we hope you can help and support us in all the activities that we are doing. We want to spread the message of India, which is a message of peace, which is a message of non-violence, which is a message of Mahatma Gandhi.
Yes.
India today is one of the fastest growing economies in the world. We are growing rapidly. It is of benefit for the people of Netherlands, for the companies of Netherlands to invest in India, and Indian companies, which are global companies today, are also investing in Netherlands.
Mm.
Together, we have a great partnership, and the diaspora can be the important bridge in bringing the two countries together.
So with these words, we close the program with our special guest, His Excellency, the Ambassador, Mr. Venu Rajamouli, Ambassador of the Republic of India. Thank you for your time, and we see you next time in Netraj TV Talk Time.